Some people think that it's okay to send messages out into space on behalf of humanity, and some people think that that's a terrible idea. Where do you sit on that debate?
The problem that I have with that is that ET, if they're out there, may not have our best interest at heart. Maybe they are more interested in grinding up our planet and just looking for palladium. I think that sending messages, deliberately transmitting, advertising our existence may be putting Earthlings at risk.
All right, for decades, astronomers have been looking for proof of intelligent alien life beyond Earth. Recent detections of a signal at the closest star system to our own, Proxima Centauri, has given us new hope. W5 science correspondent Dan Riskin is joining us now for more. Dan, good evening. Great to see you. I'm just going
to
take a cue from what we heard, saying that the signal may not be in our interest. What do you make of that?
Yeah, it's something you don't really think of. You look up at the stars and you have these lofty dreams of maybe meeting aliens someday. And then you sort of start to think, well, wait a second, what's happened on Earth every single time there's been a colonization? I mean, you get invasive species that move into a new island and take over and kill the local fauna. You get the horrible history of colonization that's happened with Europeans moving to different parts of the Earth where they wiped out cultures that existed there before, performing genocide. And so the idea that an alien race might come and visit us and we'd just get along swimmingly might be a little bit rose-colored glasses. So we really have to think a little bit about what we're getting ourselves into.
True.
As we listen to the cosmos, and even more so as we think about broadcasting signals out there.
Very interesting perspective indeed. So tell us a little more about this signal we're speaking of, Dan.
Yes, so there are a whole bunch of radio telescopes that point at the sky and that listen for a signal coming from space. These are the same things we use to talk to our own satellites, to talk to spacecraft on other planets. This is what we use to talk to the lander on Mars that just got there. But it's the same technology could be used to communicate between planets. And so if there are alien organisms out there that are communicating, they're probably using this kind of technology, we think. And so why not listen and see if we hear anything? And so we're listening to different parts of the sky. And there's a telescope in Australia that in 2019 picked up a signal from the Proxima Centauri system. Now, Proxima Centauri is the closest star to our sun. It's 4.2 light years away. So hypothetically, if someone there had sent a signal our way, we'd get it 4 years after they sent it, which in space terms isn't actually that long. It's the best you can do. It is the closest star. So this signal looked like a whistle. It was a pure tone in the microwave frequency, and it was recorded, and people have been dissecting it ever since, trying to figure out if it is, in fact, a signal that came from far away in space. If so, is it natural, or does it look like it was made by someone? And then second of all, is it just interference? Because every single signal that's been found so far has either been something natural, like a supernova sending off radiation, or it's been interference from, you know, a satellite passing overhead while they were listening or something like that.
Okay, I have very little time, Dan, but I believe you also spoke with an octopus researcher about this study. I mean, is there some relation here?
Yeah, there is. So, I mean, if you're trying to think about what an alien signal would look like, you have to think about how weird aliens might be. And so why not look to the strangest intelligent creatures on Earth and just look at how different they are from us and think about how they might try to communicate with us. Now, if it were an alien race that was sort of octopus-like and we were trying to communicate with images, which seems like a good start, we might use different colors. They can't see different colors. They might use different polarizations of light, which they can see just fine. We can't see that at all. And so it really drives home that we might be talking past each other and that when we're listening to space, we really have to have an open mind about what to expect and to try to look for things that we wouldn't think of otherwise.
Very fascinating indeed. W5 science correspondent Dan Riskin, thank you for your time and those insights.
Thank you so much.
And you can watch W5's Signal Saturday at 7 p.m. Eastern.